Seth, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Glory be to God on high, and on earth His good will towards heaven. We praise Thee, we bless Thee, we worship Thee.
Let us pray. Lord, we beseech Thee, grant Thy people grace to withstand the temptations of the world, the flesh, and the devil, and with pure hearts and minds to follow Thee, the only God, through Jesus Christ, Thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with Thee in the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen. Amen.
The epistle is written in the first letter to the Corinthians, beginning in the first verse, beginning in the fourth verse. I thank my God always on your behalf for the grace of God which is given you by Jesus Christ, that in everything ye are enriched by him, in all utterance and in all knowledge, even as the testimony of Christ was confirmed in you, so that ye come behind in no gift, waiting for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall also confirm you unto the end, that ye may be blameless in the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the 22nd chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew, beginning at the 34th verse.
Glory to thee, O Lord.
At that time, when the Pharisees had heard that Jesus had put the Sadducees to silence, they were gathered together. Then one of them, who was a lawyer, asked him a question, tempting him and saying, Master, Which is the great commandment in the law? Jesus said unto him, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it, Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. While the Pharisees were gathered together, Jesus asked them, saying, What think ye of Christ? Whose son is he? They say unto him, The son of David. He saith unto them, How then doth David in spirit call him Lord, saying, The Lord said unto my Lord, Sit thou on my right hand, till I make thine enemies thy footstool. If David then call him Lord, how is he his son? And no man was able to answer him a word, neither durst any man from that day forth ask him any more questions.
Praise be to thee, O Christ. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. This is the first time that we've sung that song in the history of St. Luke's Church, so we're going back a long ways. We just had to find out where the apes swing to and fro, and all of those magnificent mission thoughts that we have had through the centuries. Now, the sermon. Life is a series of choices. We have choices every single day, don't we? And at the core of our choices is something that is called temptation. That's Latin, and it means to test or to try or to prove. It's not a bad thing, it's a neutral thing, temptation. It's not good or bad, but neutral. And it's also in the Greek, if you look at the Greek and the Hebrew, it's the same. It is a neutral term to test, to prove, those types of things, and to try. Now, we face choices in life and decisions to do and not do. Depending upon our choices, we become either grace-filled and godly, or we succumb to the temptations of the world, the flesh, and the devil. We hear that in the prayer for this day. Temptation, then, is an opportunity for growth and to become strengthened by the decisions that we make. For growth, or it is a gateway to sin, depending on how we respond to it. It doesn't have to take us down, not at all. At times, however, it does when we make the wrong choices. Here's a story regarding temptation and sin. You know, we've been struggling with this since the second day of creation. Been a long time. Now, there was an archbishop, the first archbishop of in England. His name was Augustine, or Augustine, whatever you want to call him. He went to England with a very daunting task, and that was to convert the heathen. England and the surrounding areas were all heathen, so he had a big job to do. And Augustine was in England, and he knew Gregory the First, who was Pope at the time. And Gregory had a good mission, and he excelled in finalizing the liturgy of the church, and he also was an authority on both temptation and sin. And so Augustine decided he would write him and ask for advice and help. That's always good, because none of us know everything, and so we ask for help with people who do know whatever we're dealing with. So he wrote and asked him for help, and he had a lot of questions, and one had to do with sin. How was he going to deal with sin in England? Well, Gregory gave him a succinct definition of sin and how sin comes into being in life. He said, sin is consummated in three ways: by suggestion, by pleasure, and by consent. So now we know how it is consummated when we actually fall, not into the temptation, but fall down into sin. We now know. Let me give you a parabolic story of how sin worms its way into life in our day and age. Let's say that we know a broker or an owner of a large real estate company, and he has hundreds of agents that work for him, and one was an outstanding, young, and energetic woman. The broker's best agent. She sold more homes than all of the other individuals. And so she was also so attractive that the broker thought she was attractive, and so he told her as much. Oops, shouldn't have done that, I don't think. But she never gave him the time of day. And so, slowly but surely, he'd try again. It never worked. Nothing was going on. And he finally became a little bit sullen. And then a little bit envious, because she was so good. And then he ended up being sour with his relationship with that woman. Time went on, and he got a phone call from another agent about the woman's pushing into his territory. And so the guy was just really griping about that woman. And so the man listened, and he listened intently, and he let that man say whatever he wanted to say. And then the broker said, "I'll talk to her." So
He didn't talk to her right away. He mulled it over. And he thought about it. And finally, he came to the conclusion. He said, "This is my chance. I'll get rid of her. And then I'll be free of her. I won't have to worry about her anymore." So he called her into his office. He talked to her about the subordinates' gripes. And he actually added a few of his own, too, because he's the boss, and he can. And half of them weren't true, but it didn't matter. Once again, he's the boss. And so he then subsequently said, "You're fired." Sin is consecrated in three ways: the suggestion, the pleasure, and the consent. I think that story has all three of them floating around. Temptation is an opportunity for goodness and growth. Again, it's kind of like gold in a furnace and fire, and we have that furnace of fire in adversity, and we can become more fully God's child. But temptation is an opportunity for goodness and growth, or a gateway to sin. And that's what happened with him. His choice could have made him a better person, and therefore benefited other people. It could have proved his worth. But instead, he bit the apple. So, what are we to do in order to withstand the temptations of the world, the flesh, and the devil? There's an easy fix. Concentrate not on what you've been doing, but rather hear what the lawyer asked Jesus and Jesus' answer. That's the easy fix. "Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself." You do those two things, and temptation will exist, certainly. But sin? No, because you've focused on God, and you've fallen in love with God. And therefore, you even like the people you didn't think too much of in the past.
All things come of thee, O Lord,
and unto thy will we can never be given thee. Amen.
We offer this sacrifice to the greater glory of God in thanksgiving for the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. The intention for this Mass is to offer thanksgiving for the lives of Janine Smith, Jerry Lee Barker, and Dorothy Gallant, asking that God will grant them a place of light, peace, and refreshment. Brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable unto God the Father Almighty.
The Lord receive this sacrifice at thy hand, to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word, and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who, in this transitory life, are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. Amen. Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you into everlasting life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith unto all who truly turn unto him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son to the end that all who believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying,
Holy,
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 holy, holy, God of hosts, heaven and earth.
Blessed is he who cometh. glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou, thy tender mercy, didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made thereby his one oblation of himself once offered the full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for thee. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness to vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be made partakers of his most precious body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that, by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ, our Lord,
amen.
By whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, All honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray, and now as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all evils past, present, and to come, and at the intercession of all thy saints, give peace graciously in our days, that we, being opened by the succor of thy mercy, may both always be free from sin and safe from all disquietude. Through the same Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table. But thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come into my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come into my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come into my roof, but speak the word only. Shall be healed. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for me, preserve my body and soul into everlasting life. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him that taketh away the sins of the world.
Lord, speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come out of my roof. And speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which is given for thee, preserve thy body and soul into everlasting life.
This in the remembrance that Christ
the blood of our Lord Jesus
died
Christ
for thee.
Shed
feet on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou didst vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries. with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members and corporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men, and the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them he gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor the will of the flesh, nor the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Thanks be to God.
Hymn 276.